This is Dror Shekasuto. Thanks for what?
Baruch Hashem. I wanted today to explain a little bit about a very deep and interesting and I think very important concept that is called Aliyat HaOlamot, the rising of the worlds. Like, it's kind of how and in which way all the worlds will be uplifted, will rise to a certain higher level, higher place. Now, let's open it a little bit, stage by stage, step by step, and try to understand a little bit about it. So, first of all, are we talking about something physically, something physical? Are we talking about something spiritual? So, what does it mean, Aliyat HaOlamot, that the worlds will rise? And which worlds? We have one world that we know of, so okay, let's say that it will rise somewhere, but worlds, what are those worlds in plural? And what does it mean? Physically, we're going to experience certain changes or only something inner, like certain spiritual development, and like everyone will feel good, or like what tachlis, what in the bottom line, like what really going to happen practically. So every individual in this world, and I explained that issue, this topic many times, every person on earth and also every creation, an animal, a fish, every a bird, even a flower, experience life from his point of view, from his angle. The flower, he has a certain desire, a certain need, a certain thirst, a certain hope, like fear, like he feels from his angle. He's a flower and he's not aware to the fact that he might be more than that. He is who he is, a person. You can be an amazing person, you can hold yourself as just a medium person, but in reality you experience your life from your angle. And even if you are aware to the world and you're able to grasp that there are more people and you try to consider their feelings and emotions, and like you are sensitive, you're not a narrow-minded, self-centered person like in your own bubble, but in reality, even when you want to care about someone else and you open your heart fully, you are doing it from your point. You are trying to listen more carefully with your ears. It's like you try to think with your mind on his words that you heard with your ears again. And like it's, you're always stuck in who you are. This is a certain time tunnel that we're all passing through. In our lifetimes, there is a person that will live on earth for 120 years. He will experience his life experience through that 120 years of time traveling in this world. Now he goes to sleep, and now he needs to eat, and now he's eating, and now he goes to work, and he's talking, and over the phone, and hanging the phone. All those things are taking place in certain aspect, and that's his individual life, that's his point of view to experience the world. A deer, a goat, a sheep, a squirrel, an eagle, they're experiencing life from their angle. 100,000 fish in the same group swimming in the ocean, everyone has a different angle. Even a cell, even a drop of water are experiencing life, a germ. Every particle of creation is experiencing heat, pressure, oxygen, changes, and everyone has his own time limit. Even a grain of sand, okay, so he's lying over there on the beach, And he has a little bit of movements once in a while when some kids are running on top of his head. But except of that, like, the sun is hitting him, and then at night the darkness, and some animal passed like 500 years ago, and he was still there, and one day someone will come with a shovel, I'll take him and put him in his house, or gonna melt him to make a nice cup out of it, and like, he gonna experience life from his angle, from his perspective. Those are the worlds that every single one of us is experiencing, a different world. We are all located in one universe, but every one of us is a different mindset, is a different time tunnel that is experiencing the global world from a different angle. And by appreciating your life experiencing and understanding it, accepting it, just respecting it, letting it be, we are allowing your world to take place in the same time that my world takes place. And we now have two different worlds that are taking place in a similar time, in the same space zone, but from different angles, and it becomes to be a different world. And we're experiencing different worlds. Those are the worlds. And there are almost endless number of worlds, because the particles of creation, even though that the Creator can measure them and count them and knows exactly what's going on, we don't have the ability to say, to put a number on top of them. Only the Creator knows everything about everything. But we are outsiders. We are everyone stuck in his own prison, in his own cell, and disconnected from the rest, even though that we can look at them, but we are not experiencing them from within, from inside themselves. Only the Creator does. The Creator, he is looking at things from the opposite side, from the opposite direction, because he is behind the curtains. We are outside. We are outside, we are in this world, but this world is a world that is physical, that is blocking the light of the Creator from us as creations. Means that our souls that are connected from within to a one source, to a united source, to a one place, to infinity, to the blessed source of them all, the Creator himself, from within. But when that portion of heaven is locked and sealed inside of our physical bodies that are used as the holy chariot, as holy chariots that are carrying spirit on top of them, we as those vehicles, as those vessels, are divided from our spiritual source, and therefore we're not experiencing all the worlds at once. But the Creator, he's standing on the opposite side, and he is with you in your life journey, and with you in your life journey, with you, with you, with you, with you, with you, with me, with every single one of us. He is standing with us from within, from inside, experiencing life, also with that fish that is swimming up the stream, also with that bear that is looking from the side, also from that side of the snake that is crawling in the grass, and the sweet little hamster that is not aware to his environment at all. But the Creator is looking from his eyes and feeling through his senses and from all the angles of all the leaves, of all the flowers, of all the grains, of all the particles of creation. He is the source of life that is filling the worlds from within. Now, Aliyat HaOlamot, that the worlds will rise, it's that our mindset will climb above our cell, our prison, our handcuffed mind, our limited way of grasping and understanding and lack of ability to embrace and hold all particles of creation and understanding the complete picture, when our mind will rise from that bubble to a higher dimension, we will be able to experience the rising of the worlds. We will enjoy the eyes of the Creator, Shalom Aleichem, and welcome. We will be able to enjoy the eyes of the Creator that is being given to the righteous ones. Like the verse is saying, Enei Hashem latzadikim. The Creator gives hands, His eyes to the righteous ones, that they will have the ability to see through the Creator's eyes. Even our regular eyes, those ones that we're using them right now, those eyes are also receiving their power from the Creator's eyesight, or else we wouldn't be able to see. He's the one that can see. Like the verse is saying, the eyes of the Creator are walking all around, looking all around, and Hashem, asher hema meshotetot b'chol ha'aretz, wandering, looking around. There is no place that he cannot see. Even the darkest night of them all is shining for him like the brightest day, because he is the creation itself. He sees things from within. He is inside and outside every particle of the creation. He is the life spirit that is moving all the atoms, and He's inside the atoms and outside them, and He's the atoms themselves. He's inside and outside every part of creation. Just that we are isolated. We have been exiled from being spiritual to become physical. Our cloaks of light became cloaks of skin. Our form that was once shining and illuminating and bright, brighter than the sun, like that it's written, that the lowest, the heel of the first man was brighter and shinier than the sun. In the first place, in the ancient time, our bodies were covered only with light. We didn't have no covering that is blocking the light of our souls. Our souls, welcome. Take your seat. The Creator created us in the first place, in the beginning, as spiritual figures, forms of light. And we were walking in that way in the Garden of Eden, with no fears, with no pressure, with no limits, with no pressure on our minds. But after the sin took place, we have been started to be covered by husks, more and more layers that were blocking our minds from that ability to see the whole picture, to understand what's going on in the world, and therefore we're suffering. Today, the reason why we are suffering is only because of that separation. We're suffering because we don't understand what happens with us. If, for an example, now someone will tell you, hey, you must run and climb 100 floors. And okay, why? Like, why are you telling me to do that? Just go! You're going to be miserable. You're going to suffer. But if you know in 100% that in the end of climbing those 100 floors, you're going to make $100 million, or that you're going to live, or that you're going to earn something that is worthy for you, or you're just going to understand that you must do it to save someone else's life, or for a cause, for a purpose, you'll be happy to do it. You're going to climb the stairs. You're going to invest all your powers. You're going to have a purpose. It's going to be a meaningful act. Even if it's going to be very hard, you'll find it worth it to sacrifice those hours, that time, that power of yours into that thing, because you understand that it takes you somewhere. There is a purpose for it. But when you are isolated, when your mind is divided from the rest of the creations, and you don't see the large picture, you don't understand, hey, why I just been knocked down? Why I just been attacked? Why I just been rebuked? Like, I don't see the connection. Like, in reality, I'm just like suffering, and I need to defend, I need to attack, I need to argue, I need to fight, I need to learn. I keep on forgetting, like, every situation that is happening to us in life is divided, because we have been exiled spiritually. We've been blocked into our own vehicles, into our own bodies, and we are suffering from that separation in our minds. And we cannot see the complete picture, and therefore we're suffering. But when the redemption will take place, all the worlds will rise. What does it mean? That your world will not be blocked anymore in physicality. Your mind will expand. Your ability to grasp the whole picture will answer all your questions, will solve all your doubts, will bring you to such place of completion, of deep understanding of what in the world is going on here, that you're going to finally be relieved. And you're going to understand completely exactly why everything happened the way it happened. And you won't have no more questions, like that you don't have questions on the Bible. People that have questions on the Bible are people that are still questioning their own lives. But when you look at the history of the world and you look at the Bible, you can understand why you understand. You can understand that Jacob went from that land to the other, that Abraham went from this place to that, that they had certain relationships, conversation, things developed in certain way. Some people died. There was a hard time in Egypt. Why you can understand it? Because you're not experiencing the pain. It's already 3,000 years ago. So in a way, who cares? Like, it's a story. Not in a way that chas v'shalom, God forbid, disrespect their situation. But it is so far away from us that it's okay to understand that they suffer. But if I'm going to have to be sent to Egypt, so no. Listen, I have some questions to ask here. Like, what are you doing? But if it happened 3,300 years ago and it's already finished and they already made their 40 years journey to the Holy Land of Israel and the temple has been built, and been ruined and been built again, and like exile took place, and it's long time history, it's ancient time, you're not bothered by the history, so it's okay for you to understand. When your mind will rise to that place of understanding things from a higher angle, you won't be bothered by your own troubles anymore, even today, even in the present time. When a person experiences his life as an individual, he's exposed to the pressure, to the heat, to the pain, to the sorrow, to the rebukes, to the insultings, to all the difficulties, because he's experiencing it. But when you take your mind, or when the Creator is blessing you with a mind that is looking at things from a different, from a divine angle, from the other side of the picture, from the opposite side, from the spiritual side, you see life as a journey. You understand that this snapshot of this moment is not a one moment of a picture, is part of a whole long movie. There is a situation in your life right now that you are who you are, sitting on your sofa, talking over the phone, driving, stuck in traffic, running late. Whatever you go through in life, it's part of your life journey. It's now you're experiencing it in the present time. Therefore, you're suffering because you're late. You don't know what to do. You're looking for parking. All the fears, all the thoughts, all the patterns, the way you think and grasp life are attacking you in that present time. So you are vulnerable. You are exposed to the life pressure that is pressuring you as an individual. But if you're going to look back at situations that took place in your life 20 years ago, 15 years ago, it doesn't hurt in the same way like you were terrified while you were there. When you're looking at your life from a different angle, even if it still hurts because it's you, because you still remember, it's not the same severe pain that you experienced when you were there in the present time of that moment 15 years ago. It's not the same. It doesn't hurt the same. It might hurt. It might still wake up certain emotions and certain old memory that is hurting you, that is disturbing you, but it's not the same. Why? Because you're looking at it from a different angle. In a certain moment in time, a person, every individual, and also all rest of creations will enjoy this rising of the worlds. Our minds will climb above to a higher dimension, to look and see things differently, out of our own bodies. And everyone will understand that his life situation is not a snapshot, it's not a picture, it's not a present time moment that he needs to deal with. It's part of a future journey. And also today, when we are stuck now in a certain point in time that is before the completion and the redemption, we don't see the salvation that is being built right now and in develop. So we cannot understand the greatness of that journey yet, because we have not reached the salvation that is so desirable for us. So we're still like doubting, and we're still scared, and we don't know how it's going to finish, and we don't know what's going to be in the end, and if we're going to make it and not going to make it, and what will happen, if there's going to be a bloodshed before of it or not, only light, not only light, judgments or only grace. We still don't know, because we haven't experienced it in the present time. Therefore, we're still suffering. But after the redemption will take place, in those moments of awakeness, all the minds of all creations will rise to a different angle, to a higher dimension, and will see things from above. Means that they will see the whole movie, the whole picture of life. For an example, do you know who you are? You think you know. Yes, I'm Richard. You think you know who you are. You think you know you are Richard. But in reality, you don't have a clue who that Richard really is. Where his life journey started in the holy soul of Adam and Eve. You don't have a clue. You don't know if you've been here in this world for one lifetime or two, might be three, maybe 17, maybe 70 times you were here, and you don't know. You don't have a clue. You are disconnected from that ancient memory of the, it's called Kadam archives, from the ancient archives of before creation. You don't know where your soul came out from in the sea of souls when you were part of eternity. In that place, in ancient time, you started your journey in a time that is before time. And you started your journey jumping toward a mission into the unknown, into the dark zone, into a world of creation that has been created in the first time. Never thing like that took place ever before. And you've been sent as a person, as a portion of that complete soul, to be one of the leaders of creation. And you've been sent, and things started to go wrong, and things started to fall from your hands, and you start losing control, and then that soul had to die and had to go back in another lifetime in different bodies, in different forms, as different people, in different families. So Abraham, for an example, who was he? Abraham. We believe that we are kind of his children. We came from that family. Amazing. Abraham. Who was he? He's a 10th generation to Noach. All right. Noach, he was the only survivor, him and his family, that survived the flood. The horrible flood that took place. And he was a prophet. And he was talking to the Creator. And Abraham, he had children. And his child, Isaac, we believe that we belong to him, to his family. And Isaac, he brought Jacob to the world. Yaakov Avinu, our father. And 12 tribes came out from that family. And amazing. And they went. And they went to Egypt. And then they came back. And they conquered the Holy Land. Eretz Canaan, the land of Israel. And they received it. They inherited by the merit of their ancestors. Of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. And the Holy Mothers. And great. And then there was a huge war. And the king of Ashur came and exiled 10 tribes out of the Holy Land of Israel. And they went to foreign places, to unknown lands. And until today we're looking for our siblings, our brothers. 10 tribes we lost. 10 out of 12. It's a crazy amount of brothers, of siblings. And they're lost. Where are they? We don't know. But you know, there was a reality. Something happened. Think about a movie. Those families, they went tied in chains, in ropes. They were walking and they were working and they got married and some of them died. And they passed the torch of faith to the next generation. And a similar thing happened with us under the kingship of King David. And we experienced wars and kings changed. And a new generation came and different wars and prophets came. Elijah the prophet and Elisha the prophet. And more righteous people came. And we had King David and King Solomon after him, and different kings and foreign kings and wars and battles, and again people died and other people came to life, and the journey is continuing and the families are separating. And then there was the Holocaust almost 80 years ago, and horrible things took place, and you feel so lost. How could it be? How can it be? How did it happen? Those innocent people, innocent women, innocent men, innocent children, elders, what's going on? Thousands and millions are dying, being shot into holes in the ground, barely being covered, trying to crawl out, suffering, screaming. What's going on? Gas chambers, stoves, light, fire, smoke, water. Drought, we don't know, exile, politics, the US, the government, the Israeli government, Ben Gurion, Herzl, what's going on? It's all one very long movie. It's all takes place in reality. All those things are not the history. Connect yourself to the reality. You know who you are? You are a result of the creation. The Creator sent Adam and Eve to this world and it started to move. And you are part of that movement. And you might be the completion of that. And to become the redemption, part of that is enjoying the redemption. You might be able to experience the rising of the world. You might be able to enjoy such an amazing shift to reality that all of us gonna look at the worlds and gonna accept them, gonna understand them, gonna understand exactly why those poor guys had to be burned and why those people had to die in plagues and why they had to die while they were asleep and why those guys, they're still alive. You know that Elijah the prophet never died and he's still traveling up and down to heaven and running like crazy and doing so many things in the same time and he's still alive. And there were more than 10 righteous people that never experienced death. And they taught us and opened our eyes to the potential of people even to face the angel of death and to win and to overpower him. And one of them even was able to take his knife, his, how you call that knife? The sword of the angel of death, took it away from him and made an oath that he won't bring it back. But in the end, the Creator forced him to return it, so he did. But you have this power, this potential power installed inside of you to connect yourself to your spirit and not to be divided and blocked and locked in the limitations of your physicality. And the rising of the worlds, Aliyat Olamot, gonna take place in the time of redemption. In that time of redemption, all of us gonna look at life from a different angle. We're gonna understand the completion of the worlds. We will enjoy the spiritual blessing of seeing the reality, the truth, from all possible angles at once. Now, even when I'm describing to you this fascinating explanation on history, you're looking at it from your angle, like watching a National Geographic movie. Oh, wow, yeah, traveling in time, in history, another snapshot, another short video, another clip, another occasion, another situation, another thing. All right, another. And also the snake is crawling between the grass leaves. Oh, I can see that, but you still see that from your eyes. You don't really see that from the eyes of the snake, from the eyes of the hamster that is not aware to his environment. You don't experience life through the eyes and senses of every squirrel, of every fish in the sea, of every bird that flies in the sky, but you will. When you're gonna rise from your place to that place of above, and you will become one with the Creator, in that moment, you will experience the worlds from a different angle, from behind the curtains, and not blinded by the colors and the smells and all kinds of limitations of physicality. You will experience the worlds in their perfection. You're going to understand what really took place and why you had to lose those $1,000, and why you had to move from that house and to travel to another place, and why you had to schlep those chairs and to climb two floors and to do this and to do that. And you're gonna be answered, not because your prayers will be answered, because your mind will rise to see the completion of the worlds. You're gonna find out who you are. Not from the physical side alone, not only to know everything about your parents and everything about your grandparents and your great-grandparents that you don't even almost know anything about them. You're going to know who was that soul, who were those spirits that were playing roles as your great-grandparents 150 years ago. You're going to understand who were they from behind the curtains. You're going to recognize the particles of spirit and soul that were dressed as your grandfather, as your grandmother, from that side, from that side. You're going to understand that that was not their last lifetime. And here you met them again yesterday in the grocery store. And here, few thousand years earlier, they were playing in different roles, in different states, in different situations, and because of what that happened back then, they had to come again dressed as your great-grandparents, and because they haven't accomplished completion in that lifetime, you had to see them yesterday in the grocery store to achieve a certain tikkun, to fix something that was needed for your completion, for the completion of creation. Today, we are blind. We cannot see anything. We don't recognize ourselves while looking at the mirror. When we are standing in front of ourselves, we don't know who we see and who is it. We don't know. You look at yourself and you don't have no understanding about who you are and what your life mission is and what is your true potential. Do you want to change it? Okay. Drugs won't do the job. You need to decide to take the truth as your only reason for life. The only purpose to live life must be to be attached to the truth, to know what is real and what is not, what is wrong, to know what is right and what is wrong, to know what is good and what is bad, to define between the good and the bad, to know how to clarify the good from the bad, to connect yourself to good qualities, good attributes, to follow justice and kindness and patience and love and respect and dignity and generosity and friendship and brotherhood and all good things that a person can come up with in this world. That's the purpose of your creation. So if you are now more attached to certain things by the nature of your creation, by who the Creator made you to be, you desire certain things, you feel attracted to certain things in life, you must find the good in that. And you need to uncover the good that exists in that, in those things that are surrounding you. One will be the best waiter in the world, one will be the best scholar in the world, one will be the best, most honest Uber driver in the world, and one will be, no, that does not exist. I wanted to say an honest lawyer, but like it's a joke. Like no way, sorry. Okay? But like you can really heal people as a doctor just by really working on your motives, on your reason, why am I a doctor? Now I found myself in reality. I'm a doctor. Okay, what am I doing here? I need really to use those tools that have been given to me to help people to recover, to be healed, and not for the money, not for the title, not for the respect, not for the clean office, not for the secretary, not for the options and the potential that I can, based on my imaginations, lose my mind and be lost in this world of illusion, just to reconnect myself to an honest purpose and to be the best person I can be as a doctor, as a waiter, as a chef, as a scholar, as a businessman, as a husband, as a father, as a wife, as a widow. You need to be the person that you are and to reveal the good qualities that have been treasured inside of you. By that, you're going to rise to that level that you become spiritual, that you are being uplifted above limitations of physicality by being good. Why? Because the good is the source of life. Life are all desiring good. The flowers, they don't want to kill no one. They just want to live. They want to be left alone and to be able to finish their completion and to live. The animals, they just want to live. The fish, they just want to swim. No one really wants to kill no one else. But when our minds are poisoned, and our mind are, like we said, from within, attached to other minds, because spiritually we are not divided, only physically we are divided. You see this shark, he's swimming in the ocean, in the Pacific Ocean, he's swimming toward the shore. You think that he's cruel, you think that he's evil. You put your finger on him and you say, you must stop him. Listen, you know who makes him run? Your thoughts, my mind, your mind, his mind. Some people's mind is wicked like a shark. Some people's thoughts are evil like a snake, can be cruel like a leopard, like a lion, like a cheetah. People that are cheating each other, people that are violent against each other, people that are cruel, are connecting their mind to the creation. And when they are impure, they're poisoning creation. And therefore the animals are become predators, and everyone are vicious, and everyone are cruel, because we are not controlling our bad manners, our bad behaviors. We are not controlling our spirits to be always positive and to breathe and to be people of faith. But when we will, when we are purifying the environment. And suddenly you see an amazing deer crossing the street, and a car is stopping and letting him cross happily. And you enjoy this sight. And it happened because of some person's generosity and kindness, that he let someone else cross the street. And now that deer was allowed to cross the street and not to be run by a car. Because of your kindness, you are affecting the world when you're being positive, and God forbid when you're being negative, the same. We are those ones that caused the destruction, and we are those ones to rebuild and bring redemption. We, with our souls, with our mind, when we are allowing the good, the spiritual side of us, to control, to overpower our negativity, our sadness, our bad attributes, we'll let the light of the Creator shine and take over the world. But when we let our fears control our lives, and we battle, and we fight, and we revenge, and we're furious, and we're angry, and we want to kill someone, we're killing someone. Without knowing it even. Without understanding it even. And therefore every person must take a huge responsibility on his thoughts, on his lusts, on his desires. Because when you want something that does not belong to you, someone that does not belong to him become a prisoner in his hand. And you don't want that to happen. You want to hate that person, but you gave him the power by not controlling your own. When we are breathing and strengthening ourselves and refreshing ourselves with certain positive things that we find in our area, in our reality, you have some things that are helping you to relax. Use them. You know that to eat certain things, it helps you to digest, to feel good with yourself. Eat those things. You know that to put your head for half an hour in the afternoon is healthy for you. You must take care of yourself and put your mind to rest a little bit. If you know that you need to wake up early or that you need to wake up late, you need to believe in your senses and to count on yourself and to follow your guts, to follow your soul, to be aware and to listen to your spirit that is talking to you from within, and to follow the good and to achieve good. And when we will be strong enough to overpower our fears and our anxieties and our pressures, and to let our soul lead us, we're going to see that shift in the world, and we're going to rise to a different dimension, and we're going to see all the creation from a different angle, and we're going to experience things with no pain, and death will disappear from the world, and there will be no more illnesses and no more plagues, no more sorrow, no more darkness. The night will shine like the brightest day, and it's in our power to achieve that completion by working on our own attributes, being nice to each other, being kind to each other, desiring the truth, desiring faith, desiring trust, refreshing and renewing ourselves to serve, to commit ourselves to good purposes and cause. That's the purpose of each and every single one of us. And by doing that, we are connecting ourselves back to infinity, to the Creator that is the source of blessings. And may we see the complete redemption with our own healthy eyes real soon. Amen. Ken Yehi Ratzon. Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed this video very much. Please now remember to subscribe and like this video and share it with your friends to help spread faith in the world. For more, please visit emuna.com. May your light shine always, and your requests should be answered with the greatest blessings. Amen.